Illicit trade is a serious and growing problem in Uganda, part of the organized crimes which should be handled before it becomes too complex to deal with.
The fact that they are illicit, they are fake, means they are not registered, they are not regulated. These people have no trading licenses. Nobody in his right mind can produce a product and put it on a shelf which has no traceability. You have no address, no phone number, no website.
According to the Uganda Revenue Authority reports, Uganda loses over 900 billion shillings every year to illicit trade.
Because at the end of the day, the government is losing money, the private sector is losing money, people are dying because of unregulated regimes. And so it's important that on a continuous basis, we come together.
During a dialogue held today by the Private Sector Foundation of Uganda, together with key players in the beverages and cosmetic production, it was stated that illicit trade poses a huge risk not only to the economy but also to the health of the consumers.
People fall sick, they go to a pharmacy or a hospital, and they are given medication that doesn't work, or at the worst, it's killing them. We are seeing this in agriculture. Animal drugs are not effective. They are fake. They are not regulated. We are seeing a lot of even hardware, like spare parts. You buy a part which looks on the surface looks normal. You put it in your car, and 30 kilometers away, it breaks and people are dying. So there's a lot of this.
You report it to an officer, and an officer calls you back because those are accomplices. You become a target for being victimized. At times we keep quiet because we fear. You let out information, yet the information you are letting out to the officer is going to take it behind you, and then the business community will look at you as a treacherous person.
Issa Sechito, the spokesperson of the Kampala City Traders Association, KASITA, however, says the vice is partly blamed on the unfair taxation policies and the bureaucracies involved in the certification of products.
Somebody is ready to sell to you and your family Panadol, for whose expiry date has been removed and it is now poison.
Speaking at the dialogue, the Minister of State for Trade, Industry and Cooperatives, David Bahati, called for a concerted effort against the vice.
We need more action than more of talking. So I hope that today, at the end of the dialogue, we'll really see the action being taken, because what you have shown us in the video is very alarming.
Bahati notes that despite several laws and policies against illicit trade, the country continues to lose billions of revenue every year. He urges private manufacturers and key players to join the fight against illegal products.
It's really a creeping danger to our economy. It is a threat to our health. It's a threat to our economy. It's a threat to our revenue. And it's a potential threat even to our security.
It is reported that at least 23% of cigarettes on the Ugandan market are not certified, while over 30% of beverages are illicit. Rachel Nachwala, reporting for the news.